to one of the big kitchen trends of the year, fermented food. Sharon Flynn is one of the leaders of this food revival at her fermentary, and her workshops are booked out months in advance, so we're happy that she's with us here at Studio 10 this morning. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
How are you?
Good. Between pickling and fermenting food?
Yep, there's a big difference.
What
pickling is when you use vinegar and heat.
Okay.
So you're still preserving the food to go for years on your shelf, but you're actually killing all the bacteria inside the food so that molds and things don't grow, which means you're actually eating no real life.
Okay.
Yeah, you're essentially kind of cooking it too. Whereas fermenting relies on the bacteria on the vegetables to preserve it. Yeah.
Wow.
So it's raw. So you can keep it for years, but it will remain raw.
Oh.
Yeah, which is...
Have you got to have a Fowler's Vicola, though?
No, actually.
A what?
A Fowler's
It's a beautiful
Vicola.
Jar.
What's that?
Pickling jars.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, well, it's an Australian company, actually. We've been around for years, Fowler's. But you can use any old jar to ferment.
Okay.
You don't need to buy expensive things.
Well, what are we fermenting today?
Well, I thought we'd start with anything people can make at home right now, which is a simple sauerkraut and also brined veggies. These are brined veggies. So they look like pickles, where you normally see that would have, for example, this cauliflower. You'd normally, what we're used to is vinegar and sugar, and then you heat it up in a water bath.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
This is not. This is just salt water and a few herbs and spices.
Okay.
And the whole point of the fermenting is for the flora of your gut, is that right?
Yeah, well, it would have started off. Humans have been fermenting since before we had fire, pretty
wow.
much.
Oh, well, let's get into it. So we've got our shredded cabbage.
I've done one
before fire.
Yeah.
So you've shredded your cabbage here. And
where did they get the jars?
So, all right, this is a... So they would have wrapped things in mud and buried them and used the temperature.
Oh,
and,
right.
Yes, because for
like
fermenting...
Like a honey.
Yeah. For fermenting, it's also about the environment. So you want to lock out the air.
Okay.
So, and so use salt.
All right.
So
let's get into it.
I was messy.
That's okay. That's fine.
So this is just shredded cabbage.
Okay.
Yeah. So what we want to do is add some salt to kill off any of the pathogenic bacteria. So we rely on weight. So this is half a cabbage, but it weighs about, say, a kilo.
Yep.
I had a hard time writing my book because I go by palmfuls. It's about 30 grams. So you use about 2% of the weight of the cabbage.
Okay.
Okay.
And then the important bit now is
to massage it. You've got rock salt there too.
Well, I like to use actually really fine ground sea salt. Not Himalayan, just Australian sea salt.
Okay.
It's available. That's right.
Okay.
Good
so
job.
What's so next?
Get
after
it
you've
all
massaged
through.
The cabbage.
So you can keep... Actually, I have huge wooden pounders that are really great. Pounding. Good, quite cathartic.
Okay.
But this one I did earlier to show you, that is just salt.
Just salt and cabbage, and it goes all
and it's
squishy.
Brought out the water in it.
Great.
See that?
Okay.
So when you get, ideally you would pound away and massage it until it gets like this, or you can do what I just did and sit it aside for a little while.
Okay.
And then give it a good massage just to, I don't know, stimulate the cells.
That's a very
open them
happy
up a bit.
Cabbage, I think.
Yeah. And then next thing is I like a bit of caraway. You could do juniper berries, you can do celery seeds, whatever you like. Just a little bit, because what's left here was that, and it's going to shrink.
Yeah.
So you don't want too much.
Just a little sprinkle.
Flavor. Yeah. So we're going to mix that through.
And then.
So this one's sauerkraut is going to rely. So we're naturally fermenting. There are some ways of thinking that you would add bacteria that you buy from a packet, and that's I'm totally against that because you don't need to.
Okay.
This is. All you need to do is rely on the salt to kill the pathogenic bacteria that might be on the cabbage and then lock out any air.
Ah.
Don't add water because it'll ruin the beautiful flavour.
Is that all sauerkraut is? Just salt
That's
and
all
cabbage.
It should be. Yes.
Wow.
Yeah. And
I like it
stays
with vinegar,
good.
Though.
No, but open one of those up, you'll swear there's vinegar in it. There's none. That's what happened. That's why it's called sauerkraut.
Ah.
It goes sour. And so that's the lactic acid bacteria working. And that's
so
what's
that's
lacking
really
in
good
our
for
guts.
Us.
Mm. That's what's
and
lacking.
And you're pushing it,
so I'm trying
right
to get
in.
All the air out.
Yeah,
we don't want air pockets.
Can I just ask, what is that?
That is an airlock. So
when
this starts fermenting, the lactic acid bacteria love sugar. They'll eat the sugars on there and the yeast and gases will form.
Yep.
And then you need the gases to get out. So either you release the lid, open and close it every day, or you get one of these guys, for example, or that, or this. They all have systems that allow air to escape.
Right.
That's a healthy environment.
But it can't get in.
That's right.
It gets
so
out,
one of these
but it doesn't get in.
$2.50 at a home brewery store or Bunnings or something.
Right.
And just get any old plastic lid that you might have and drill a hole in it. Get a little, see the rubber bung there? One of those.
Yep.
stick that in, fill it with water, and that'll keep the air out. So this is just, we've just made
so
it ourselves.
So how long is that going to take for us to...
Well, it's up to you, really. Any time from about a week to 2 weeks, but I like to leave it... At the fermentary, we leave it for about six because that's beautiful, and then you put it in the fridge.
Yeah.
So in this case, we're not using an airlock because I just want you to know how simple it is. You would want to cover it with a weight to keep the juices down.
Yeah.
To keep the juices over it. I don't think we have a weight here.
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter. A rock will do.
We could use this onion.
A rock. Yeah, you can. You can. You can use an onion. Pop it in.
But that's not going. That's not going to mess up the.
No, it'll make it taste a little oniony.
Oh, yeah.
And there you go.
How
just
fabulous.
Set it aside. On. Yeah.
I like this return to old style cooking. Mm. And Sharon's book is called Ferment for Good: Ancient Foods for the Modern Gut. Sharon Flynn, thank you so much for joining us.